Good morning, dear students. In the previous class, I have taught you about our constitution. Yes, that is the meaning of constitution and what is the importance of our constitution and the drafting committee of the constitution. Yes, and the constituent assembly. Yes, and the drafting committee. Yes. So also we have discussed about the preamble of constitution. Okay, so in this class we are going to discuss about our constitution, our constitution's features. Okay. So features of our constitution. Yes, so first one is written constitution. Yes, so our Indian constitution, it is in the written form, and this is the lengthiest constitution in the world. Yes. So Indian constitution, it is in the written form and it is in the lengthiest constitution of the world, because every functions of the government and powers of the government, it is in the written form. That's why it is very lengthiest constitution. Okay, as we know, there are 395 articles was in the beginning, but nowadays that number, it is increased to 465, and there are 22 committees. So that all functions, powers and articles, that all in the written form. That's why our Indian constitution, it is a lengthiest constitution. And the structure, power and the extent of power of three organs of the government, such as legislature is there, executive is there and judiciary, that all functions are explained in this constitution. That's why our constitution, it is a lengthiest constitution. Yes, and there is a single constitution both for central and state governments. So India, it has only one constitution, that's for central and as well as state governments, and therefore the size of the constitution is big. So in our India, there are two types of government is there. For example, state government is there and central government is there. All the powers of central government and as well as state government, that all powers, functions are in the written form. That's why our constitution, it is very lengthiest constitution, and our constitution, it is in the written form. Next, republic. Yes, so the constitution has declared India as a republic. Yes, and in the case of republican system, there is no rule for the king. Yes, as we know, India is a republic country. Yes. So our constitution came in, it is adopted on the 26 January 1950. That's why our constitution declared India as a republic country. Yes, and in this country there is no rule of the king. Instead, there is a rule of elected representative by the people. Yes, and India, which has this kind of political system, is known as a democratic republic. Yes, so the president, he is elected by the representative. Yes, and the president, he is the head of the state or the country. He is always elected directly or indirectly for a fixed period, unlike monarchy where the head of the state is king or queen, enjoying hereditary position through succession. Yes, that means the president, he is elected by the representatives, by the people. Yes, there is no monarchy. Yes, that's why our India, it is republic. Yes, and as you know, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, he is the first president of the Constituent Assembly, and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, chairman of the drafting committee, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, he is the first prime minister of free India. So first president of India is Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Okay, so republic means the head of the state or president, he is elected by the people. Okay, that's why India is called as republic. Next one is fundamental rights and duties. Okay, the constitution guarantees six fundamental duties to citizens at present. So in the beginning, In the beginning, there were seven fundamental rights, but the seventh fundamental rights, that is the property right, it has been removed. So that's why now there are six fundamental rights are there, and the state can never pass any law that curbs these fundamental rights. So the state government or the central government, they can't pass the laws that curbs these fundamental rights, okay, or the fundamental rights are not violated. And in case of violation of fundamental rights, the judiciary has the power to rectify it. If someone people's fundamental rights are violated by state government or central government, so he can appeal to the Supreme Court or the High Court. Yes, and the citizens cannot exercise their rights as per their whims and fancies. And the 11 fundamental duties are there in the constitution. Yes, so in our constitution there were fundamental duties are there. So 11 fundamental duties are also explained there. So let us discuss about fundamental rights. Yes, so in the part of third part of the Indian constitution, so article 12 to 35, it gives the information about the fundamental rights. As we know, first article, that is 14 to 18, it gives the information about right to equality. Next article 19 to 22, right to freedom. Article 23 to 24, right against exploitation. Yes, article 25 and 28, right to freedom of religion. Article 29 and 31, cultural and educational rights. Next article 32 35, right to constitutional remedies. Yes, so these are the six fundamental rights that are mentioned in the third part of Indian constitution. Okay, next there were 11 fundamental duties are there. For example, let us discuss about these duties. First one is to respect ideals of constitution, that is we have to give respect to the national flag and national anthem. Next to cherish ideas of our national struggle for freedom. Next to uphold the unity and integrity. Yes, and to defend the country and render national service. Next to promote the spirit of common brotherhood. Yes, we have to adopt a feeling of brotherhood and value and preserve rich heritage. We have to value and we have to preserve the rich heritage. Some monuments are there, we have to preserve them, and to protect and improve natural environment. Yes, there are so many natural resources are there and environment is there, so we have to protect them and we have to improve the natural environment. And we have to develop scientific temper, and we have to safeguard public property, that is we have to save our public property. For example, buses are there, roads are there, government buildings are there, we have to protect that all property. And to strive towards excellence. And last one is to provide opportunities for education to child between 6 to 14 years. So that is fundamental, 11th fundamental duties. Okay, next one is a secularism. Yes, so India is a secular country. Okay, so secularism, the constitution upholds the principle of secularism. The governments are expected to make a non-discrimination on the basis of religion and are expected to treat all religions equally. That means secularism means our India, it has not adopted as any religion as a national religion. That means all religions are equal. So that is secularism. Okay, next one is independent judiciary system. Okay, so the judiciary system, it is independent. Yes, and executive and legislature and has adequate powers. Neither the government nor the parliament can interfere with the functioning of the judiciary. Yes, so no one can interfere with the judiciary. Yes, and we all are equal before the court of law, and all have right to justice, and it is the principle of the judiciary. Yes, next one is universal adult franchisee. That means those who completed 18 years, so they can get voting right. Okay, and that we called universal adult franchises. That means all citizens are eligible for voting without any discrimination, and then a good government comes to power. That means those who completed their 18 years, so they can take a right, they can get a right of voting. Okay, next one is seventh, that is election system. So India has a democratic type of government. Okay, and in the past 6 decades periodic election have been conducted. That means every 5 years there is elections, and the system of democracy have been adequately deep rooted in our country. Yes, as we know, every 5 years there will be elections. Okay, and it is still satisfactory system in spite of certain demerits. Okay, so there are so many demerits are there, but this election system, it is very very better to India. Okay, so this is all about our constitution. Yes, thank you for watching this video.